I now request Dr. Anuradha Agarwal, Principal Scientist and Officer in Charge DCCU and General Secretary ISPGR, to kindly introduce today's speaker.
Thank you, Dr. Kavita. Most respected dignitaries on the dais, respected Dr. Paroda, President ISPGR and Chair of today's session, lecture session, Dr. P.L. Gautam, former Director NBPGR and former President ISPGR, guest of honor, Dr. Bawa, today's speaker for the second DS Athwal Memorial Lecture, Dr. Kuldeep Singh, Director NBPGR, dignitaries of the dais, Dr. Nadesh, Dr. Karihalo, Dr. Parikh, Dr. Vasan, Dr. Tyagi, Dr. Mahajan, Dr. Umesh, heads of division, officer in charges, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. It's my great privilege and honor to introduce today's speaker, Professor Kamaljeet Singh Bawa, a man of high eminence, an articulate speaker, a thoughtful visionary, and prominent leader in the area of biodiversity, conservation and evolutionary biology, and sustainability, and a globally recognized and highly decorated scientist. Born on 7th April 1939 in Punjab, Professor Bawa received his graduation, post-graduation and doctorate degree in botany from Punjab University, Chandigarh. And after receiving his PhD in 1967, he moved to the United States as a postdoctoral research associate and instructor at the College of Forest Resources, University of Washington. He received the Maria Moores Cabo and Charles Bullard Research Fellowships at Howard University in 1972 and worked as a research fellow at the Gray Herbarium, Howard University, from 1973 to 1974. Thereafter which he joined the Department of Biology, University of Massachusetts, Boston as an assistant professor, became a full professor in 1981, and since 1986 he is a distinguished professor of biology over there. His early work led to discoveries of unusual breeding systems, novel pollination mechanisms, and long distance gene flow in tropical forestries, which changed the prevailing notions about population biology and evolution of these trees. He was amongst the first to consider the role of resource allocation and sexual selection in the evolution of plant breeding systems, and he advanced new mechanisms for the evolution of almost every major type of breeding system in plants. Later, he extended his work from population biology to sustainable use of forest resources, conservation of large tropical landscapes, and climate change. Professor Bawa's concern for global conservation issues led him to establish new institutions for conservation and sustainability, and new models for international cooperation in fostering sustainability. Among Dr. Bawa's most significant achievements is the establishment of Ashoka Trust for Research in Ecology and Environment, acronymed as ITRI, which he started in Bengaluru in 1996. This innovative knowledge-based conservation and research not-for-profit organization was designed to scale up the models of and approaches to sustainability science. A3 fosters the generation of interdisciplinary knowledge to address pressing challenges emerging from the interaction between environment and development. Dr. Bawa's commitment and work for Indian biodiversity through A3 is one of his very commendable and highly recognized achievements. Besides ATRI, Professor Bawa is associated with several other development and research-based organizations, and he, with his contributions in various fields of plant biology and forest ecology, has been bestowed with enormous number of awards and recognitions and accolades, and listing all of them would take a long time. But just to mention a few prestigious ones, he is elected fellow of the Royal Society since 2015, honorary fellow of the Association of Tropical Biology and Conservation, fellow of the National Academy of Sciences India, American Association of Advancement of Science, and so on and so forth. The list is very long. Professor Bawa is the author of more than 200 publications, and author and editor of 10 books, monographs, and special issues of journals, and details of which have been provided in the leaflet given to you. He has been an associate editor and editor of very important journals related to these fields. In today's Anthropocene geological era, a new biodiversity science is taking shape across the globe, focused on understanding the